Alright, let's do some Binding of Isaac. It's been a while. If you're watching later on YouTube, thanks for clicking. Hope you've been enjoying so far. Yeah. I'm trying to do more with this. Just, we're kind of at a point where the losses are real, huh? It's okay. These tainted characters. But the other thing, you know, the infrequent play is what's making it. But since I've gotten a bit through the backlog, I can kind of go back to this for a while. I'm not purely convinced that I'm ever going to finish this, it's just some of the characters are really tricky. But we'll see. I'll try my best. That's a good start. Stuff like this, I should not have been hit by that. Okay. What am I aiming for here? Okay, I mean, I'll do a sand run. That seems fine. Damage reduction is a good call. No transformation yet. Okay. Depression. Damn. It's a waste of a transformation. I don't know if that was worth it overall. I guess. Okay. It just makes sense, right? That's money based on, well, health based on money. Oh no, wait, it's stats up on money. Disregard, wrong thing. So, aim to spend more money. Interesting. Oh, okay. That's perfect for the Devil Deal stuff.
Range up.
Screw it. I need to do this, right? Yes. Have the right idea. Oh, no. Horrible item. Well, that's a no-brainer. Eh. Think that item's good. It with the Devil Deal, assuming there is one. Stop. stupid ghost. Ah, it's this one. All right. Okay, how should I play it? I feel like I should play it like this. I mean, either way. There we go. Debating on taking a loan. Oh wow, okay. That's quite the freebie. Definitely gonna be greedy. Nice, good pickup. Ooh. The scariest part of this whole thing is just playing as a lost in this part. Best, but it's a freebie's a freebie. All right, cool. I don't have to stress for a while. So if I find myself with a lot of money, this could work out really well. Okay, so the idea is I don't want to risk it too much. I hate the alternate path in general. So I can return to the standard path for just one stage. Just so I have a little bit of a better time. Not a great pickup. If I'm lucky, I'll get to re-roll it. Easy. I do want that. It does kind of ruin things for a little bit. This room sucks. It really does. I hate it so much. I gotta hang on to these two bombs. I can't use another bomb. Wait, what? What is that doing over there? It's a weird room. Ooh, that's an interesting purchase. One more bomb now. I feel like this isn't gonna give me enough. Okay, well. Stupid ass room. Ugh. Okay. This is why. I can always change my mind if I feel like this isn't going well. For now. Oh yeah, I can use the GB bug to reroll stuff. I keep forgetting that. Getting ditched immediately. Hey, chat member, I'm good, thanks, but hope you're doing well. Want to focus on getting completion marks. Didn't change into anything. Ah. Change. That's better. I never used to like GB bug, but it's kind of grown on me a little. That sucks. Can't spin in the store. I want to get more stats. That's too spicy. Let's just see what happens. I might not even be able to continue. Let's see. Stupid room. Oh, this thing. Yeah. Oh no, it's this boss. have a problem. Okay, I did pay the toll. Oh crap. Ugh, I went through the door. I don't think I could have gotten it either way. Judgment. I'm gonna have to do a standard run. That was gonna be tough. This was probably the right choice anyway. Really? I've made devil deals just way too weak compared to what they used to be. I mean, in the sense of like how much health loss you have these days. Had to try. I feel like I do a lot better when I do angel rooms. Rise. If I can get the, money for it. Whoa. I didn't realize I did that to the blade. Just want to see if there's anything else I can do with the health before I do that. Alright, now I'm gonna go get it. I can do with this. I'm gonna try and play this game more often. I've just gotten so rusty. Blame Zelda for that one. I'll probably visit the shop. If I can be quick enough, I might be able to pick up those hearts with the sword. Boss early on. No. Leave it like that. Let's see what I can do with this first. Okay, nice. No, 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 no. Debating whether I should go down the alternate path or not. Hive mind. Okay. I'll trade the red heart for a soul heart. I didn't go in here just to give the odds of a planetarium. Why not? Alright. I'm just gonna try and get the dark room mark. It's gonna be here. Yeah. Take the gamble because I got the hive mind. Okay. This is if I can figure it out, this would be useful. Wait, was that correct? Come on! Bounce into the right spot, please. There we go. Okay, hold on to that. I think I'll be able to recharge it, unless this... I had to take a stab in the dark. that's probably not going to give me what I want. I can't believe those two rooms I just got. Detrimental.
Range down.
Ice baby. This is a good one. Definitely one of the stronger babies. Okay, let's see. I'm hoping I can find the room. Oh, damn. Okay. I have plenty of keys. Hold up. Leave that for the time being. Yes! Planetarium. It worked. Okay. Ah, shit. It's Mars. Wait, is it Mars? That's Mars, right? Mars, Isaac. It's Mars. Yep. It's the worst one. Alright. That's so unlucky. I can't believe I got Mars. for the sake of safety. More attempts. There it is. Got it. Worth it. All right. That's all I was waiting on. I guess that makes up for the planetarium room being a bust. Hey, I'll take that. Alright. That worked well. Damn it. I won't be able to do this properly. Dumb curse. Temperance. I'll try my best, but probably not gonna happen. I did that the wrong way around. Supposed to use it on the way in, not the way out. This is probably worth taking just for a minute. I'm sure that thing is about to burst open. No. Oh boy. This is not looking good. Where's my hearts from the money? I don't know if this one was right. Okay. Heart! Thank you. Desperate times. Oh. Nice. Caught it again. All right, what's it gonna be this time? Just a range up, but I guess. Alright, it did give me a heart. Rude. Okay, I'm gonna go back and get the trinket I left behind. Assuming I can navigate my way back there. And then up here, right? Yes. Okay. This has not been very lucky. Right away. Okay, this... Now we're talking. Got the spooky tears. I mean, at this point I may as well do the extra rooms. Probably beneficial. I may be missing out on angel rooms, but this is made up for it. It's a devil item. Interesting. Oh. Oh. Yeah, but I don't have a way across there easily. Just ate the heart. Guess. Beat the key. Okay. Now, usually this item is a no. However, in this circumstance, because I can do this and sort of make them useful again, I think it is worth it.
Isaac!
It's just more stuff flying around. Also not bad on the sword. Alright, well, I did all I could. How's this nut still not broken? Again! Yes! I've done it again. I've made the most of this item, I'm happy. Yum heart. Not sure about that. It's like a delay, really, on the inevitable, if I'm relying on it. Yeah, honestly, not bad. One of the few times I think dunce is actually useful.
Judgment.
Okay. Okay, hold on. This is like setting me up for a donation thing.
Judgment.
What did I just say? Okay.
The chariot.
Easy freebie.
Experimental.
No, that works. That's fine. I'll take that. Another one. I mean... I guess I may as well blow everything up. Never know when you're gonna find a hidden item. Damn. Gotta remember that aim's on an angle now. I honestly prefer it when I'm just shooting. A spider hit me at the last second and I lost the angel. Hello, Denisiwa. Oh, I'm so annoyed. I can't believe that just happened. Nah, I'll just keep going. It sniped me at the last second. Alright, well, I guess I just have to find the red door. Okay, heal.
The sun. Friends till the end.
Okay, so now I can look where I think it is most likely. Alright, let's see if I'm right. First try. I'm trying to just get completion marks on the tainted characters. I've done all the base characters. But I took a break from the tainted characters because it was kicking my ass for a while, so I might be a little rusty. But I do want to try and get as close as I can to finishing it. It's just some of these characters, ugh. Thinking of Tainted Eden specifically. I think that's the one that's going to cause me the most problems. You saw in the tags that I'm Australian. Yeah. I mean, you want me to do a voice? I don't know what you're after. I might not be able to pull it off. It might be disappointing. How is this not cracked? I've had it for the whole run. Alright, well. Oh, the TF2 sniper? Nah. The problem with the TF2 sniper is, like, he's... He's got a cadence that I can't do. And he says shit like,
holy dolly.
But see, my voice doesn't go that deep. I mean, beyond deep. I just can't do it. I can do the Australianisms, but... All the curses. Ghost. Oh, this is annoying. It's because I blew that up, that's why. Yeah, I mean... It's just not in my vocal range. I wouldn't be able to do it justice as someone that's a fan of like TF2. I'm screwed.
Oh, hold on.
Oh, damn it. I hate this curse so much. I should just do what most people do, which is just turn up the contrast when that curse happens. I'm gonna do that next time. The curse is just annoying. Yeah, it's F. How far am I on Tainted Lilith? You know what? I don't remember, but I think that's one of the ones that I've done quite a bit on, if not all of it. I'll check next time I die. I'm having a big losing streak because I haven't played in... when did Tears of the Kingdom come out since then? Oh, I fucked up. Unless I got a heart. Oh ha ha ha. Oh, ha ha! Alright, I'm just gonna... Yeah. Bad. Yeah, I've finished her. I think I did enjoy playing as her, so she's done. I mean, as it stands, I'm not doing too badly. It's just, I kind of reached the point where... It's just when I played Tainted Eden that made me so annoyed. Alright, anyway, I'm going back to him. Play someone I enjoy from on a losing streak. I mean, just because I'm losing doesn't mean I'm not having fun. It's like... Doesn't matter if you win or lose, as long as you have fun sucking. Alright, I'll get better at it. Just have not played in a long time. It's all muscle memory. When did I first start? The Flash game. I've been playing this game since it first ever came out. I've sunk so much time into this over the years. It's not something I play all the time, but collectively over the years, between the PC version, the PlayStation version, the PS Vita version, the Nintendo Switch version. So, yeah. So we're both old. You're as young as you feel. You can have people in their 40s behaving like teenagers. You can have people who are like 16 behaving like they're in their 30s. I know I certainly acted a bit older when I was younger. It's just a matter of perspective. I think the moment, like, I strain my back or something just from moving, then yeah, I can admit I'm old. That's like, oh no, yeah, that's the body just giving up at that point. Until then, I think I'm fine. I'll start talking about Metamucil on stream. I mean, here it's like, generally speaking, most people turn up in about an hour. It's, I don't know, Australia's a very annoying time zone to stream from, because the time that people show up, at least for me, is more or less when it's like 10 o'clock at least here. What am I doing? I'm losing to Dingle, stop it. Pretty much when I want to go to bed, that's when everyone's around. It's just how it is. I've talked to some people that are larger Aussie streamers. Like, I know a couple. They're not big by any means, but they have to get up at like 5 a.m. to be able to catch the good Twitch time, which is when Europeans and Americans are both on. So that's pretty much a choice, is either stay up super late or get up really early. And as a night owl, I just refuse to get up early, so usually finish work, have some dinner, or play something for a while, and then people turn up, and then I'll probably stay up later than I should. Rinse and repeat. Thank you for the follow, though. You just don't sleep. Ah, there's a solution. I should have considered that. There is a whole idea of polyphasic sleep, which is cool, but the society won't allow it to be practical. It's not healthy to not sleep. Well, by not sleep, do you mean not go to bed early, or do you mean you get less than, say, 6 hours of sleep? Because sometimes when people say they don't sleep, it's mainly that they don't sleep at the time that most people sleep at. Like, that's deemed normal. as long as you get like a solid 6 hours in, it doesn't matter when, as long as that happens at some point. It doesn't? Oh, well. I tried. I get a lot of night owls in terms of Americans. That's what I try to tell them. It's like, it's fine, don't worry. More of a vampire than a night owl. Yeah. I mean, vampire is also in the same crowd of people that do night shift. There's also that. It's like, there could be nothing wrong. It's just you work night shift, which is a thing. If I had to take one thing away from Australia, what would it be? The extreme Australian accent. Just the one that's like, ah, oh, yeah, now I'm gonna sound like this, yeah? Bit more nasally. And then the Americans are gonna talk about putting a shrimp on the barbie, because this is how we all sound like normally, really? Like that accent. Just get rid of it. Most of us don't talk that way. And a large percentage do. But it's just like, I hate that accent so much. It's like nails on the chalkboard. You know someone who doesn't think Australia exists. Yeah, well, you got me. I'm a paid actor. That's why I'm able to play games. Because only children play games and Australia isn't real. So it just doesn't add up, right? Like, I'm not a child and I'm playing games. How could a real person be playing games on the internet? Gaslight the rest of Twitch into not thinking I'm real. I mean, all I'm going to say is, like, when it comes to that sort of stuff and that kind of thinking, I'm just glad that I'm literally the first you can be away from it. I mean, we have dumb people in Australia, but I feel like that's just a whole nother level, you know? It's alright, I'll just stay here in my non-existent paradise. I'll be fine. I'm just a pair of floating hands with a voice. There you go. Nikto knows. See? Hey, Nikto. Thank you. looked at chat. I would take it to like a whole other extreme and just be like, no other country exists on Earth except the one that you're currently in. It's just the government trying to keep you in this country, man. Debating whether I should go down the alternate path. I guess I can try. If it doesn't work out, just come back. Doesn't Tainted Samson encourage you to play poorly? I mean, if you want to take aggression. I can't say that's my excuse right now, because it's just I haven't played this in a while. Almost walked into that. You can interpret like the transformation is one of two things. Go as quick as you can or just stay at the same pace, because it's like he's gonna probably transform quick enough again anyway. This game is the best at making disgusting things cute. Or like things that are otherwise horrific and satanic. Cute. Alright, let's just do the boss. Oh, not this one. I'm definitely not gonna come for the bonus item. Too risky. Not when this curse is active as well. Alright. Cute gross is on point, it is. Glyph of Balance. It'll encourage more soul hearts. Won't necessarily happen, but it'll encourage it at the very least. I'll be interested to see Edmund's next game, because it's supposed to be... I haven't seen much of it, but it's just like, it involves cats and breeding them, so. And again, it's the same, just gross out cute art style. I have to make sure to turn up more often. Well, thank you. Appreciate that. I don't always play the same game, so this is just like the start of the evening. But if you're down for seeing a bunch of different stuff, then yeah. But Isaac will be in the regular rotation so long as there's something for me to do. Probably reach a point where I'll either win or give up. Ah, oh, that's disappointing. Out. Damn auto carrot. Yeah. Gets in the way of good typing. It's pretty tricky to type when you have a carrot in your hand just suddenly. There's one more. No. We haven't even reached the part where I, like, start making noises out of frustration or... I suppose I have a little, but... It's just another thing I'm known for. I've had a very long day, so... The energy might not be there 100%. But stick around long enough and you'll hear it. What, me groaning? Not just groaning, like... The noises I make that make it sound like Gollum is dying or something, or like Donald Duck is being strangled. Just, I don't know, take your pick. I don't always, not always. There are times where it doesn't happen. Depends what I'm playing. But I don't do it to be funny, it's just... It's just how I've always played games, it's just... This visceral reaction when things don't go my way. The one where I am trying to be funny is like when I... I try to do the warrior impression. And just say rude shit. That's like... That's when I'm trying to be funny. Yeah, I was about to do it. Nope. Nope. Refrain. Throwing a little here. Wait, it's fine. Hive mind. It's cheap. I accidentally did the warrior world. The warrior voice at work. Briefly, like. like, yes. Oak was like, is that Wario? Like, oh, yeah, right, sorry. I forgot where I was for a sec. I mean, when you're sharing company with someone who doesn't believe that I'm a real person, like me here, hello, it's very hard to be excited about certain prospects, let's just put it that way. Rock. Give rock. Listen, I'll tell you something that will make you feel a bit better. The dumbest conversation I've ever heard here was at a bathroom stall. And, you know, two dudes were using the urinals.
Something.
And one of them walked away from the urinal. And the other one was like, what are you doing? What? You gotta flush it. It's like, nah, the flush is automatic, man. And then proceed to debate for the next 10 minutes about whether or not urinals are automatic. And it eventually went to like government shit. Like I wish I could do it more justice by remembering just the utter insanity and how derailed that conversation was. And they were really having at it. And then the way the conversation ended was a third dude walk in and was like, ah, you got any smokes? And then, you know, the conversation went to about cigarettes and that was the end of it. So. There are stupid people everywhere. It's just, the question is more about density. It's a numbers game at the end of the day. I decided not to go down the alternate path. I'm just gonna... I don't have a good build. They're not automatic, no. Those ones weren't. There was a button quite clearly above it. I feel like I definitely made the right choice here. So everyone pushes that after washing, wait, after, before washing their hands, after holding their penis, yeah? I guess. But then you wash your hands afterwards. Some of them, they're on a timer and they just periodically flush. Listen, when it comes to a public bathroom, restroom, whatever you want to call it, I think you're gambling from the moment you walk in. Like, hygiene practices do go out the window. I mean, some of my female friends have told me horror stories of shit that happens in women's bathrooms, so you know. I think touching a button that, with your hands that touch your penis, like maybe 15 seconds sooner, probably not the highest on the disgusting list. So in case you're new here, this is the kind of stuff we talk about, I guess. Don't leave the house or pee ever. There you go. There can't ever be a problem if you don't interact with people. As long as you don't touch your penis again before you wash your hands, I guess it's okay. But then, it's fine if you touch your penis again before you wash your hands, because you're going to wash your hands. It would be bad if I touched my penis after I washed my hands. Yeah, that would be weird. But, like, it doesn't matter. Anything, any number of things can happen before I wash my hands. As long as the hand washing happens. Doesn't matter about the order of operations, like, you know, you could touch the button first, then your penis, then the button again, just to be sure. Then you're like, oh shit, I didn't shake enough, so you touch it again, and then you touch the button a third time, but then you wash your hands and everything's fine. That's what we call variety. Yes, today I believe I will touch my penis first. Button last. Ah, man. I should be paying attention to what I'm doing. What a weird time to come in. Yeah, well, do you want the context or would you rather just... See, I didn't finish that sentence on purpose. Need the context. All right, well, the context is... If you push a button and then touch your penis, is okay as long as you wash your hands. Talking the button at the urinals, just to be clear. I was just saying that once I heard a dumb conversation where two dudes were debating about whether or not the flush was automatic, because one of them just walked away without flushing. And was a heated conversation. As heated as you can get. Like, they sounded like they were about to fight each other. Until a third guy came in and started talking about cigarettes, and then they both shut the fuck up about it. You feel strongly about not touching the penis after touching the button because you only wash your hands. So, are you saying I can't touch the button first? What if there's like, here's a conundrum, what if there's a massive mess and it's just like, ugh, no, I have to touch the button first. I need this mess has to go. It's like that derailing that you have to clean up the mess. Like sometimes you have to push the button first. And people aren't considerate and they leave a mess. If anything, pushing the button first is the more sane option because you're just double checking that all the filth is gone. Yeah. Ah, ah. If you want to be completely hygienic, it would be walk in, push the button, wash your hands, go back, do your thing, push the button, wash your hands. Is it like a whole other language? Okay, Australia is 90% British English, and then the rest, the final 10% is slang. The accent is a result of just heavy drinking that transformed the British accent into... Yeah. You know, like that. But as a language, we're pretty much British English. There's even some shared slang. So. Hold on. You don't use urinals because you're too scared of the auto flush splashback. What if you're halfway through and it flushes? It's a fair point. I haven't come across that conundrum, but I guess I live on the edge a little. Urinals with buttons are becoming less of a thing because they do them on a timer. Because apparently it saves water in the long run, supposedly. Here in Dixieland's basically another language. But that's just a result of slang, surely. Like, it's not that you formed a new version of English, it's just you use slang more often. There are some parts of Australia where, like, the best way I could describe it, it's basically, it's our version of America's South, you know? They just, the way they speak, it's not only the accent, but just certain words. Like, instead of sandals, they'll be like, plugger! Like, I broke my sandals. I busted me pluggers the other night! Just like, shit like that. They'll just talk like that. Or like, oh my god, I can't believe what just happened. Versus, oh fuck me sideways! Bad income! It's just, that's what it becomes. That's just Southern British. You know what? That's what Australia is to the UK. But, you know, as much as the Brits can joke about Australia, like, the fact of the matter remains is they sent their criminals to a place that had nicer weather than the UK. I don't know if those criminals learnt their lesson, really. They would have gotten off that boat and just been confused as fuck. It's like, what the hell? It's like, it's a nice beach and sunny weather. What is this? Like, they're just expecting the guillotine to drop at any minute because it's just too nice, and then they realize, oh shit, wow, they fucked up. Haven't learnt my lesson at all. I might go steal another loaf of bread and might end up somewhere even nicer than this. You guys have spiders and stuff. Listen, this comes up so often, so I'm gonna put it this way. Think of absolutely the most dangerous thing you can die to, whether it's animal or human related, like, or as a result of humans being stupid. Whatever that is more likely to happen to you than to me get bitten by a spider that kills me, or an animal that kills me. You're more in danger of dying than I am. That's the truth of the matter. That's just like the stereotypical, oh, Australia's gonna get you killed if you go there. Fucking giant spiders the moment you get off the plane. If this is how it is, if you're in the middle of nowhere, if you're truly in the middle of fucking nowhere, which is the case anywhere in the world, then yeah, a spider may or may not be your downfall. You might have me on that one. But otherwise, it's just you're more in danger where you live. You are. Like where I am, they have this like annual study thing that they release talking about the cities in the world that are like the best places to live. Not to visit, to live. Like, there's a bunch of metrics they use against that, which is, you know, crime, poverty, just ease of access to the internet, just a whole mix of things that makes life easy. And where I live is constantly top 10. In fact, it was number one for like 7 years straight. But anyway, Australia is as dangerous as the middle of nowhere, wherever you live. That's my TED talk. It's like if I went to the Grand Canyon and then came back and went, shit, America's got a lot of holes. Fucking hell. Don't go to America. Massive holes everywhere, man. You're just like talking about one thing that exists in the middle of nowhere. Oh, you better be careful, you'll fall into a pit. This is promising. Because this is effectively a bunch of free items if I can just... Alright, anyway, I'll stop on that topic. It happens so frequently. Just when people get to know me a bit. Inevitably, it comes up, oh man, I would love to visit Australia, or how about those spiders? I'm like, yeah, well. I just got jumper cables as an item.
Yes.
Okay, good stuff.
I'm dead.
think I just lost it. It's okay. This is the annoying variant, the one that just refuses to reappear. Yeah, that's pretty much it. It's like, if you go to a country, and then just based on the first location you go back home and say the rest of the country's like that. And it's just, you base that off the middle of fucking nowhere. We got to like some country town for population of like 3. And then I'm like, fucking hell, they lied about those buildings in America. Fucking tiny. Me local Maccas is bigger than that shit. Stereotypes. Yeah. I mean, you can blame Hollywood for that one, honestly, like... Crocodile Dundee did a number on Australia. Just, I guess don't let the fear of something happening be the reason you don't do something. I guess that's it, right? It's like, oh. Because I might run into a spider, that's why I won't go visit a country like Australia. Like, just extend that to your car. Because you might get in a car accident, why bother driving it? Oh, just got solar liver. Yeah, this is a knife. I know, right? That one gets me. Honestly, my favorite one when it comes to Americans is just when they ask about anything that Outback Steakhouse has. I'll never forget it. I had a friend from America visiting and, you know, asked them what they wanted to do. And they were like, all right, we need to get some food. I want to have a traditional Australian blooming onion. And I was like, oh, yeah, sure, no problem. Just one thing. Tell me what the fuck a blooming onion actually is. And then they described it. Oh, so it's an American restaurant that has lied to you about what Australians eat. Like, we just deep fry a whole fucking onion. That's how you think we are in terms of food culture? I see. I mean, I know we were British at one point, but like, I think... I'm sorry, that's a stab at like... food culture in the UK. A blooming onion is not, in fact, just a whole deep fried onion. Okay, well... I don't know. I'm sure they do other stuff to it, but I'll tell you what, it's not Australian. Nothing from that restaurant is. You know what Australian food is? Australian food is like a mix of Southeast Asian and... basically any other country that immigrated here. Or region. And as far as unique foods go, which isn't even that unique, it's like... the meat pie and... just snack foods is probably like the other Australian stuff.
justice.
They do that there as well, Nick, though. What, they call things French with no ties to France, but it sells. Yeah, that's true. Do you want to know how American food gets marketed here? When something gets marketed as American, it's basically over the top, like, just, you know, you're gonna take a sandwich, you're gonna add bacon to it, then you're gonna deep fry that sandwich, right, in batter, then you're gonna put more bacon around the structure, then you're gonna put that in batter and deep fry it a second time, and then just add two slices of pizza on the outside for good measure and sandwich that together. Just anything that is that level of excessive is, like, yeah, that's American food. What kind of pizza? The double bacon pizza, of course. I have relatives in America. I know how far it actually gets taken. And, you know, those things that I'm just like, that sounds like it's going... I just by listening to it, I can feel the diabetes. Just by hearing what's in it. Deep fried butter, I have heard of that. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Oh, look at this. It's beautiful. About those noises. It's okay, I have flight. Wait, no, I don't. Thought I had flight. It's okay, I got a health up. Oh, my movement speed is so bad.
Feels like I'm walking on sunshine.
Whoa, what was that? I wasn't referring to the diarrhea, just, like, they became rings randomly. Okay, I just got... I think without anything, like, the portion sizes as well is probably the other thing I've heard, is just the difference between here and there. You know what I'm surprised we didn't adopt from Europe? It's just beer or any sort of alcoholic beverage, for example. Yeah, that. What is that? It just comes in cans, just small ones. For a nation of drinkers, like, our sizes, just, they're tiny for some reason. When you deep fry butter, it doesn't melt. It's the same concept as, like, if you've ever heard of deep fried ice cream, which is a thing, it's just flash fried. So then... it's just very quickly done, and the middle of it is still, you know, ice cream. Deep fried ice cream is really good. Deep frying butter, man. Please help. I wish I could. I wouldn't even begin to know where I could start with that. How would I logically convince someone that would do that, you know, to stop? Like, they're counter-arguing, no matter what I say, you know, I could give a very nice speech about how it's bad for them and, you know, they need to live a better life and that they're better than that, just like a bunch of different things, really. And then they'll just turn around and just chew on a stick of butter. Like, that's all they have to do. They don't even have to say a word. It's just like, that's it. Just convince them Australia is real. See, the problem with... Life's too short to try and, like, convince others of that sort of stuff. The problem with that is, no matter what you say, they have it in their mind that that is the way things are. It's one thing to convince someone that wants to listen, but there are people that'll just... No matter what you say, you could break down their argument and make everything they look say, you know. Everything they say looks stupid. But ultimately, they can just turn around and say, psh, you're just a shill, you're just paid by the government. Like, in their mind, that's enough for them. That's it, they won the argument in their mind. Is the Australia not a real thing, an actual conspiracy? It's a conspiracy, yeah, by flat earthers, typically. I don't want to say it, but it's like, pretty much, it seems to be around people that don't leave their surroundings. Like, they kind of just stick around in either their home state or their home country, and they don't venture outside the world that they know. And that's why they think like that. Or just talking to as many different people. Like, that's one reason I like being on Twitch and streaming, is because I get to talk to people from different parts of the world and hear about life different to mine, or just outside of my own knowledge, you know? Like, I learn things. I might actually win. But yeah, when it comes to that, there's just no convincing. That's just it. No conversation can really change that, unfortunately. Yeah, what is that effect? I want to know what that is. That is redo the floor, but why would I want to do that? There's no benefit to that with this. I just don't understand how it became specifically Australia. I guess because we're the only... ...like, country that's a continent and an island, and just the stuff you hear about existing here just sounds absurd. It's just like, because you can't see something, therefore it doesn't exist. That's the premise of it. I can't walk to this place, so it doesn't exist. That's more or less the gist of it. I think Australians should just start a America doesn't exist thing, you know? Just be like, America doesn't exist. Just in retaliation for the whole Australia doesn't exist thing. What? There's no way a place like that could really exist. How? I don't believe it. I can't walk there. I mean, the rest of the world speaks a little bit British, like, and this country doesn't? No, they don't exist. I hate this ghost.
Where is it?
Losing my mind. Okay, I think this is the right direction now. That worked. I got the holy mantle now. Oh, I see what that is now. It's when I transform. That's when it does that. It's like Brimstone's effect when you transform. I mean, that looks cool, but it's pretty impractical. Okay. I might actually get somewhere. No, thank you. No, thank you. No. Okay. Hold on. Maybe now this will be good. Can get health. Spoder. I'm gonna be taking interest in sport for like the first time in shit, I can't even remember the last time I took an interest in sport, but like... This is, again, I don't have an interest in sport, not a comment on the sport itself. Just be crystal clear. But they have the World Cup for soccer at the moment, women's soccer. And Australia is like in the quarterfinals, so... The leader of our nation is like, if Australia reaches the finals, they're gonna declare a public holiday. And if they win, then it'll be an annual public holiday. And, you know, the last public holiday I had was in June, and I don't get one until September. So that sure would be nice to make this public holiday drought just less. So I am... gonna be following that, because then at some point it'll be like, oh, I just got a day off work. So I'm hoping they do well. About as patriotic and sports I'll get. Hope they win so we get a holiday. Yeah, I mean, I want them to win as well. Like, don't get me wrong. They've done well. But it would be nice. They're playing France tomorrow. So that's who they're up against. And then... I forgot who it is. I think it's like Sweden versus England. No, Sweden versus Japan and then England versus someone else. I forget. But I can't remember who are the two we'd be going up against theoretically. Or hypothetically, I should say. Hypothetically. Who made that holiday promise? Albo. I mean, it's open for debate and discussion. Don't know. Oh, this was like... No. Alright. I achieved a goal. Hooray. More important, the curse is over. That's it. Constitutes a win. I want to see how much further. That's interesting. I could restart the floor and have another chance at continuing the run.
Health up.
Hmm. I don't think I've ever done this before. Let's see. Ah, boo. All right, pick that one. Little brimstone. And this one. Brimstone bombs.
Health up.
Ancient power. I'm just gonna get all of them. All right, that went bad. I kind of want to continue it, and I just never get the way forward when I'm like this. always when I'm not OP. That's when it's like, yeah, continue. Look at that. It's so good. Oh, okay. Our Prime Minister, would I give you more holidays? I don't want to deal in that hypothetical. I don't... That's not something I care to think about. Hey, Colin, how's it going? Death beam. Well, I most definitely want this one. Honestly, about time. Get wrecked. Please give me a portal. No. No portal. Well, I tried twice. Last day of summer school, then they're home for 3 weeks. Well, enjoy the last year quiet, I guess. Still gonna just, you never know when, so I could still get Dad's key and get into the fight. It's a possibility. Sure. That's it anyway. I did what I could. Alright, well, it didn't let me continue, but a win's a win. Finally. Oh, your Sagittarius son's going to kindergarten in September. Oh, that's funny. Like, one sentence is like, oh, they're gonna be home for 3 weeks, but then it's on the other hand. kids. Cool. That number is now one. It's not negative whatever it was. Okay, so now... it doesn't need to do the Polaroid. Wait, I did normal. We don't want to be doing normal. La, 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 la. Mixed emotions, I get that. It's like, the majority of the time I consider myself to be pretty introverted. But then there are times where I want to be extroverted. It's like, Oh, wow. Okay. I may have just won already. Yeah, it's like, sometimes it's happy to hang out with people, talk with people, listen, but then there are times where I just, you know, don't want any of that and just want to be alone. So 1 minute I could talk about being glad about peace and quiet, but then other times just reminisce about non-quiet things. Don't kill me, please! Okay, so... Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. No, okay, I need to stay alive. What the hell? They got bones. How was Friday? Busy. But I'm glad work's done for the week. That's awesome. Oh man, I have to survive this, come on. I might just have to get that for padding. The thing that's been talked about right now is just the soccer and just how everyone wants the public holiday. So we get the extra public holiday. We won't find out. So like tomorrow is the quarterfinal and then they have to win a semi-final. So if they win the next two games, then the discussion is there'll be a public holiday for the final. And if they win the whole thing, there's a discussion where it's like an annual thing. But nothing official. Suppose we'll see. There is a downside to the shot, but you can overcome it. I wish you would get the day off after the Super Bowl. I kind of already have that. With the Grand Final Eve public holiday that we have here. That's the next public holiday in September. Imagine a day off for football, like. It's just, there's more to it. It's because the sport was invented here in the state that I live in. So there's historical significance behind it. Football is soccer. No, it's not. So football is Australian football, which is like a completely different sport. Soccer is just soccer. I'm just glad I can just keep using this. Jesus, weapon.
Justice.
Yeah, it's fine.
Health down.
What is this? This is one. Okay, this is unprecedented, but I'm going down this path. I don't usually do this. But I feel like with this kind of start... Okay, other item. That's good. Oh, I just got this. Love it. Okay, I'm not doing angel. I mean devil. This is all good guy runs. An item. Come on. Damn. Alright, we'll try with one. I'm gonna take a loan out. Damn it, come on. Oh well. Alright, well, I tried. Could be here, let's see. It's not. Okay. Next floor. Really, really have to mess up. I just have to play carefully, and then this will probably be a win. PhD, okay. Oh, nothing. Oh man, that was just insanely brutal how much that did. Ah, killed my ally. Alright, it's fine. Okay. I don't have bombs, I need bombs. Daughter took over Animal Crossing, so you only get to play in the morning. Oh no. Because things are in real time, that... Okay. Yeah, they're both equally bad. Because things happen in real time, nothing's open at that time. Or at least the morning's just starting. I don't get to see a lot of the stuff. Alright, well, I guess I'll go get the thing. What a small floor. Change of time, true. Oh, I'm gonna be so upset if this thing hits me. This is pretty much removing the danger of being a melee character.
Ooh.
That almost sniped me. Okay. Everything is fine. Oh, it has bomb. Okay, get this. And that. I guess I can continue this path. I'm opting for the harder path, why not? One up. That's a nice insurance policy right there. This is the downside of this shot type. On the one hand, it's great at a lot of things, but if you need to defend yourself in some cases, it's so annoying. Nice. Alright. This is game on everything. You can get on pretty much everything. Oh, damn. If I can get that item. Okay. So now that's gonna, in boss fights, it's gonna charge up the friend. This one. Because I have luck, so it just means more shots. Oh man, this is getting chaotic. They just wail on the boss. I don't even have to be near it. I can't believe they get a little club as well. That's insanely strong. Okay, I think I've been everywhere. Good. another Curse of the Lost. Ugh. Not a whole lot of people would get a Whose Line Is It Anyway reference. Reaching that point, less and less people are gonna understand that. Damn it, I lost the heart. Still don't like this path. It's just everything is a bullet hell. I guess. I got egg. Okay, health for sure. See if I can get the claw. Push the button. Alright. Boss first. Okay, this should be nice. Just what I have. That is so disgusting. Unbelievably disgusting how much that does. One, two. Wish it would take red hearts, but that's fine. Ah, I didn't go in the angel room. I thought it'd still be there. That was dumb of me. Believe the item was good, or just believe that the item was bad. But until otherwise proven, it's both good and bad. I can still get in there. There is a way, it's just likelihood probably very low. Okay, one more switch. Buy the cloth. Alright, let's see. Judgment. Okay.
Judgment.
Where is this last switch? Or plate? What I'm believing in. It's just hoping that that was going to lead me to it. Thank you. Okay. Well, let's hope this goes well. Oh, they stick with me. That's nice. I mean, if they can clear a path. I have not done this in a long time, so let's hope I don't butcher it. How much the controller vibrates. It's so distracting. I mean it, it's like, I've never felt this controller vibrate more than this here. Like, I'm worried it's gonna break. Can't I turn up the vibration? Maybe. It's basically permanently on. Interesting. This is a ballsy gamble on my part. Ugh, I need one more penny. Is there nowhere else I can get money? One more penny, that's all I need. I could take a guess where the hidden room is. Bullshit. Okay, hang on, I can get money out of this. That'll do. Sure, it would give me it. I'll see what the card is. I'm taking my time here. I'm not gonna win awards for like speeding through it. Oh, this was not worth it. Wow. Oh, it's gonna leave me one shot. Oh my god, I'm an idiot. All right. I didn't see that rock. Empress, not a heal. Throw one more. Probably honestly not bad for this because it means they travel quicker. I don't think it's bad. I'm just very low on health, and that's a very concerning thing.
Oh,
I see it. Okay. Everything's fine. Oh, jeez. Those things are scary. That's interesting. This is a cool build. They're colored. I kind of like this. Mausoleum one, so. Oh, it's Lilith. Uh oh. She has to go quickly. Okay, got her. Very good. Just need a tank up, that's it. Just get health. Jeez, I almost walked in. So, I walked into it. I was impatient with it. Hangman. Okay. It's not ideal. I guess the damage is nice. The problem is stuff is going to do more damage after this floor. If I had some sort of defensive move, that'd be great. Candy heart, Okay, attack fly, The one downside to this is having so many minions is that it's hard to see sometimes. Spare health, maybe. That counts as spare health. Shit. What an annoying room. This is interesting, though.
This is number.
We didn't actually pass out. Oh, that's all good. Alright, I'm used to people just vanishing. Get a lot of people just using this as their wind down. I'm just gonna have to try. I don't think I'm gonna be successful here. Just have not been able to increase my health. Like, everything's been a temporary measure. So unless something changes soon, it's not looking good. Let's not prolong it. The only reason I went in here was just to see if maybe I could get more health. Or if there was something that was quite clearly a no-brainer. There was nothing. I think the only thing that might be a saving grace here is the fact that I'm spawning minions. I just gotta get through two more floors. This is gonna be rough. Ooh, yes, please, thank you. Okay, free minion. So I gladly take that. I think if I can keep increasing my minion count, this might be okay. Like, maybe that might be enough to win. Of course, I can barely see what I'm got. That's too much shit on the screen. Okay, do it. Get me in the corner. I just need to keep better track of my character, that's all. Temperance, no thank you. Ah, damn it. It was retracting. Okay. This is coming with me. It's extra health. Thank you, Iron Jesus. Okay. Alright, I got rid of it. Oh, this boss sucks. I was already in... Alright, I actually feel good about this. I was already smacking things away, so... Survived. Okay, now I just need to reach the end. Oh no. No, thank you. Keep the card. Need to find the correct path quickly. Oh, that's no. Oh my god, this is like one of the worst floors to get. Room really screwed me over. Okay, found it. Yay! Oh, okay. I was gonna say yay for base health. Alright. I don't think I'm gonna win. I have no damage reduction. Damn it, I got hit. Alright, try again. What is hitting me? Well, I'm screwed. Ah, alright. I tried. I never got any health. It's just the whole time. Not a single health increase, a permanent one. It was all just temp health. Which, there's nothing wrong with it. It's just I'm so rusty that I was really hoping I'd get normal health. It just never happened. Alright, well, that's enough runs for today. Chat, I'm gonna make some tea, take a short 2-minute intermission, but then I'm gonna continue Final Fantasy 16, so... If you're here for Isaac, or are watching later on YouTube, on the VODs channel, thanks for tuning in. And remember to button press and all that stuff if you want to support the channel. Or if you want to watch me play something else, I'm sure two other videos have popped up on your screen, so... Maybe you want to do that. I don't know. But till next time. Bye, YouTube.